This dude here, this actually, I think this was 2003. The state of Florida had never seen a retro fast. I had never seen a retro fast. My brother-in-law calls me and says, he lives on a lake. He and my sister have a nice little house, and every year at her birthday, which is right around the 4th of July, they have a big party. And all their wealthy friends with their big boats come to their house. And David goes, and who's a civil engineer, by the way, with a septic tank. Mark, my drain field's clogging up, and I don't want to have to rent porta potties, right? So I said, okay, I'll get a retrofast. I gave him the retrofast, and he paid to put it in, or he and I put it in, and then I forced him to sample before, during, and after the big party. So anyway, how's this thing work here? Next. So I can read the logo, the top to you there, but the concrete tank was at least 45 years old. It's in an old section of Orlando. It was in excellent structural shape. There were no manholes anywhere in it. This guy from Total Septic knew right exactly where everything was. There was a little notch in the corner, in the bottom right corner, right by his right foot. They'd knocked the corner off of that tank 20 years ago, 30 years ago, to pump it out. And they just had kind of a little wad of stuff, piece of plywood with plastic wrapped around it, jammed in that corner. So that's how they pumped the tank. He knew right where it was. It was amazing. He hadn't been, so they pump it all out. Now, what you see down there in the bottom is that little retrofast cap. We were just figuring out where we were going to put it. So this is the homeowner, civil engineer, not in the wastewater business. He's in the structural plywood business. But so he and I went out there and we dug the whole thing up, cleaned it all up. We can see we're back in the corner of the house. Now that's their Florida room right there. We got the blower right in the corner of that. Luckily there was a piece of electricity right next to it that we could hook to. And they have a nice little porch too, to just on the other side of that green bush. So the blower and the exhaust vent and everything was right next to their, or is still right next to their patio. So the deal was when if you were in their house and if somebody took a shower in the guest bathroom and then you flushed the toilet, you could hear it gurgle throughout the house. In this picture, that's his outlet tee. The original vitreous clay outlet L was still intact and in place. I always thought that stuff was hard. That's the first time I'd ever cut it with a diamond. My slices right through it like butter.